Hi, I'm Bob Welds. Let's talk about pi. Pi is one of those things in math that comes up again and again. It's used in formulas for the circumference of a circle, the area of a circle, the volume of a sphere. Well, I hope this won't be too disappointing, but it's really a simple thing. It's the ratio of the circumference to the diameter of a circle. That's it. Here's one way we can see what that ratio is. First, let's measure a circle's circumference. Remember that the circumference is the distance around the circle. Sparky will use a tape measure to measure the distance around this pipe. Okay, the pipe measures just a little less than 22 inches around. Now, Sparky's tape measure only measures to the nearest 16th of an inch, so let's keep that in mind. It's not exactly 22, it's just a little bit less than 22 inches. Now, let's compare that to the diameter of the pipe. Sparky will now measure the diameter of the pipe. The diameter of this pipe is right at 7.0 inches. We can set these measurements up as a fraction with the circumference on top. This shows that the circumference is bigger than the diameter. But how much bigger? Well, just do the division that the fraction is telling us. See? 22 divided by 7 equals about 3.14. You see that we can write the division problem different ways, but they all mean the same thing. 22 over 7 is the division problem. We could also write it like this. Or like this. Or even like this. We just have to key it into the calculator with the top first, then the division key, and then the bottom. So the circumference is a little more than 3 times bigger than the diameter. This is true of any circle. The circumference is a little more than 3.14 times bigger than the diameter. 3.14, does that sound familiar? If you hit the pi button on your calculator, you will get a number that's very close to 3.14. Here, I'll do it on mine. See? 3.14159265. This number is very close to the actual value of pi, but even it is not exact. Nobody knows the exact value of pi because when you calculate it, the decimal places go on forever. Try this sometime. Measure the circumference and diameter of a piece of pipe or a wheel or anything round, and divide those measurements the same way, with the circumference on top, the diameter on the bottom. Your result will always be some approximation of pi. If you could measure exactly, your number would be exactly pi, but you can't do that. That's another story for another day. Well, I hope this helps. I'm Bob Welds, and these are Weld Notes.